How do I encrypt a disk? Everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Whole disk encryption is an important aspect of security for many people. If you encrypt a disk properly and your computer falls into the wrong hands, those hands won't be able to access your data. Now, the average computer user may or may not need to use whole disk encryption. It kind of depends on the type of data you're storing and the level of concern. However, encryption in general is an important tool for business and government users, particularly for portable computers such as laptops and tablets. If you're running the professional edition of Windows or better, and your disk is formatted using NTFS, most Windows hard disks are these days, then Windows can encrypt your disk using BitLocker. Much like encrypting folders, the technique is pretty simple. Let me show you. We're here in Windows 11, which happens to be Windows 11 Pro, and I'm looking at my local disk C, the system disk. All we really need to do is right-click on it and click on Turn on BitLocker. This step is key. You must save a copy of the recovery key somewhere. Should you ever not be able to sign in, or for other types of BitLocker, forget your password or lose a USB key, having a recovery key is the only way you can regain access to your encrypted data. Now, exactly how you save it is less important that you save it somewhere, so that someday, months or even years from now, you'll have it should you need it. Saving it to your Microsoft account is the default, and honestly, that's a fine approach. You'll find a list of these BitLocker encryption keys or recovery keys in your Microsoft account. However, given that Microsoft accounts can also occasionally get compromised, or you could lose access to it, if you lose access to your Microsoft account, you wouldn't have the recovery keys you need. So what I'm going to do here is save this recovery key to a file. You can print it if you want to. I'll simply say that if you do, should you ever need it, it's going to be a fairly laborious process of typing in what it is you've printed. So I'm going to save to a file. And it won't let you save to the drive you're encrypting, which kind of sort of makes sense, I suppose. So I'm saving it here to another drive. You can see that I've done this once already. I'm going to go ahead and save this now. Now, in order to show you just what it is we've saved, I will quickly go ahead and have a look at it. Here's this BitLocker recovery key. This is the one that I just created. It's a text file, so if I double-click on it, it'll open up in Notepad. There's the information. This is the recovery key you would end up having to type in laboriously, like I said, if you only had a printed copy of this. My recommendation is that you do both. You save it to your Microsoft account, because that's the most convenient by far. And you save it to a text file like this, and then save that text file in a secure location. Remember, anybody with this key, with what I've got highlighted on the screen here, could decrypt your hard disk, should they ever need to. Depending on your situation, typically chances are very low that somebody A is going to steal your disk and then B want to get into it to the point where they would actually try to find this file. But like I said, if you're in a sensitive situation, that may be something that you want to make sure is stored securely. So with that out of the way, we'll go ahead and minimize this because BitLocker drive encryption is still here. So we'll save it to the Microsoft account. We've already saved it to a file. And now we'll hit next. How much of your drive to encrypt is also an interesting question. Remember that when you delete a file, the data for that file is not actually overwritten, so that there is actually data that could potentially be recovered from the unused space on your disk. If that's an issue, then you want to make sure that that gets encrypted too, so that somebody can't recover something from your disk should they ever find it. However, if it's not a concern, and honestly, to me, it's rarely a concern, encrypting only the data that is currently on your disk is going to be faster. If you're not sure, do the whole thing. It's the safest, and the only cost, if you will, is that the encryption is going to take a little bit longer. We'll click on next. Honestly, this is also another, I'll call it a red herring. You want the new encryption mode. The only time you want something other than the new encryption mode is if the disk you're encrypting is something that you might remove from your machine, so it applies to, say, USB drives, and then take to another machine that does not have the current version of BitLocker. Unlikely. And even if that were the case, you could find a machine that has the current version of BitLocker. So, new encryption, do this. Run BitLocker system check. Honestly, my understanding is all this is really doing is running the moral equivalent of check disk slash F, which is fine. It should do that. It should just make sure that everything is proper on the disk before it sets out to encrypt. Now, we hit continue. Now, as it turns out, we need a reboot. So, we're going to do that. And we're back. Notice we're back in Windows, but also notice that we have this notification showing us that the encryption is in progress. You can continue to use your machine while your hard disk is being encrypted. How long will this take? That's almost always the next question that comes up. I can't answer that. It depends on whether or not you chose data or entire disk, how big your disk is, and honestly, how fast your disk and machine are. In this case, this is a small example machine. I've got an SSD. I did specify the whole thing, but it's not going to take me too long. You can see that it's making progress as I'm speaking. However, you could be with a large hard disk looking at hours, to be honest. So that's why, yeah, keep using your machine. It'll be fine. The good news here is that BitLocker is strong, secure encryption, and it's built into Windows. Once encrypted, it's pretty much completely transparent. The bad news. BitLocker is for Windows only, and it's not directly available on Windows Home Editions or for drives formatted using anything other than NTFS. While it can encrypt disks to be shared with others, only machines running a compatible edition of Windows can decrypt the drives. Using BitLocker assumes you trust Microsoft, particularly if you use the option to store a backup of your recovery key in your Microsoft account. So, what are some alternatives? You can use a tool like VeraCrypt, whose website I have on the screen right now. It's a free third-party tool. We actually used it when we were talking about encrypting a folder, and it does support, among many other things, whole disk encryption. Now, I'm not going to cover this one in detail here because the VeraCrypt documentation is actually quite good. The good news here is that in many regards, VeraCrypt works almost exactly like BitLocker. Once you specify the passphrase to gain access to an encrypted disk, the operation is transparent. VeraCrypt is free. Volumes encrypted using VeraCrypt should be inherently portable to any system, including non-Windows systems on which VeraCrypt has been installed. VeraCrypt works with all editions of Windows. The bad news? Well, as with BitLocker, if you lose or forget your passphrase, your data cannot be recovered. There is no back door. There's no recovery key. VeraCrypt is third-party open-source software, which may raise trust issues for some. Now, the approach that I actually prefer using VeraCrypt is, again, very similar to something that I outlined in How Do I Encrypt a Folder. Rather than using whole disk encryption, I create a VeraCrypt container that is as large as possible on the disk you want to encrypt. So let's say the disk you want to use is 100 gigabytes in size and it's empty. You'd use VeraCrypt to create a container as large as possible, approaching that 100 gigabytes. The container would appear on the drive as a single large file. When you mount it using VeraCrypt, another drive letter appears on your system. Files you read and write on that drive are transparently encrypted in the VeraCrypt volume. When it's dismounted, the drive letter goes away and your encrypted data cannot be accessed. The good news here is that the VeraCrypt container volume can be copied to another hard disk or even another operating system and can be accessed as long as VeraCrypt is installed and you know the passphrase. The bad news is that this specific approach does not work for system drives, the drives containing Windows, and from which you boot your system. What's most appropriate for you is going to depend on your situation. Some general guidelines include, to encrypt your system drive, I recommend using the system-provided encryption if you can. That means using BitLocker in Windows. If you can't, or for some reason you really don't want to use BitLocker, use VeraCrypt to encrypt your system drive. For any other drive, particularly those you might consider sharing with other machines, consider the almost whole disk approach that I outlined using VeraCrypt containers instead of whole disk encryption. It's technically less complex and somewhat less fragile. It's also somewhat more flexible, allowing you to copy that container to other drives or other machines should you be so inclined. Regardless of which approach you decide to take, make absolutely certain that you have your recovery key or your passphrase backed up, preferably in multiple ways. Without them, your data will be lost. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/23111. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.